In this video, I'm going to be showing you how to do excavation work in Revit by using retaining walls. I'm going to be showing you a couple of examples with both cut and fill approaches. Let's go. Now, quickly, before we jump into Revit, I would just like to ask you to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com. I'm going to link it up in the cards above and then also down in the description of this video. If you're serious about mastering Revit, we are an Autodesk authorized training center, and we offer over 150 hours of content dedicated to all of the important and complex topics inside of Revit. So now, without any further ado, let's jump straight into Revit. And also a quick shout out to ArcGuide for the idea for this video. So anyways, let's now get started with the first step, which is going to be to set up the phasing. We want to do this correctly, we want to do it right, so let's do the phasing first. So to set up the phasing, you want to select your topography, then you want to go to the properties panel, and down here on the phasing tab, you want to make sure that this is set to existing, and then hit apply. Okay, it's going to be gray like this, and that's fine. Then you want to go to the masking and site tab, and here we have the graded region tool. You select that, you pick the first option, which is just going to create a new phase for your topography, and select that, and then click on the first topography. Now I'm just going to hit the escape key a couple of times and then repeat that step for the second one. Okay, now moving forward, let's place our retaining walls. So I'm just going to go here to the site plan. We have these reference planes that we're going to be using as, well, reference. And now let's go to architecture, go to wall, and we're going to be using the basic retaining wall. Now for this wall, I'm going to set the base constraint to level 00, and then let's create that wall over here, just like so. For the second one, I'm just going to set the base constraint to level 1, and then set this to 0, and let's place a wall just like this. Hit the escape key a couple of times, go to the 3D view, and this is what we get as the result. Okay, now let's get started with this first one, where we're going to be applying the fill. So you select the topo solid, then you go to modify sub elements, and now I'm just going to go here to the site plan. So here we have that wall in place, and we're just going to be adding some points. Now I'm going to set this option here from absolute to be an offset from surface, so from the topo solid itself, and then make sure that it says 00 here. So basically any points, they're not going to be making a change to the topo solid, they're just going to be added there as points. So I'm going to add one point here at the beginning, at the end, and also in the middle on the outside face of this wall. And then do the same thing for the other wall, just like that, on the outside face. This is going to help us kind of keep the topography on this side of the wall where it already is. Then I'm going to switch to the split line tool. Then I'm going to switch this to elevation and set the elevation to, let's say, 2600. Hit enter, and then I'm going to basically just create a line like this, and then another line like that. Now let's go to the 3D view and see what we have. And this is the result. This is what we've wanted to create. So as you can see here, if I change the phasing, so if I change the phasing to existing and hit apply, it looked like this. Now when I switch to new construction, it looks like this. I can also switch this to show complete, just to show kind of the end result. And this is what we have. So we have kind of filled this with earth. And yeah, that's the result. And it looks really, really good. Now let's do the second one. So for the second one, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go again to modify sub elements, switch to the site plan. And here it's a very similar process. So you go to add point, you make sure that this is set to offset from surface, and it's also set to 00. Then you add points along the exterior edge or the exterior face of this wall, just like that. Then you switch to split line and switch this to elevation, set it to 2600, and then go like this. And another line like that. There we go, perfect. Now we still have these points here, which might give us some issues. Now I'm just going to select this. Actually, let's go to the 3D view Again, okay, so in the 3D view, this is what that looks like. So you can see this is kind of lifted a little bit above. So let's go to modify sub elements and see what's going on here. So these are at 3000. So now I'm just going to select this one, set it to 2600 and do the same with the rest of them. Hit the escape key a couple of times and this is what we get. So this looks a little bit odd. So I'm just going to select it, go to site, go to modify sub elements, and then these I'm just going to try to move a little bit towards the outside like that. Move this one and even this one, we can move it. And yeah, so now when we go back to the 3D view, yeah, it's going to look like this. So it's a lot cleaner and a lot nicer. Also for this wall, you can adjust it however you like. So for example, you can go to edit profile, select this, select the corner, and then just bring it down to kind of follow that topography, just like so. Hit finish, looks like that. And then we can do the same thing on the other side to achieve the same result. Remove constraints, hit finish. Yeah, this is the end result. So there we go. We can do very easy work with topography, with cutting and filling, using the phasing and using retaining walls. And it's not that complicated. Now, if you would like to get access to these Revit project files, as well as all of my other Revit project files, all of that is available on my Patreon page. The link is up in the cards above and also down in the description of this video. Thank you for watching, guys. Make sure to check out my website, balkanarchitect.com, for more Revit courses. There I have over 120 hours of content, and I'm adding more each week. Make sure to subscribe for more videos, and also I've added a video over there that might interest you as well.